Hello, Luis Ponce here from Mind Body Motion, and in today's video, we're going to be covering the hip, a joint. So going back to two videos ago, we look into how the feet gets connected to the ground and how we generate force from the floor up. So the foot and the ankle joint, they're primary on contact with the ground, and then from there, we generate force as we get contact with the ground, so we absorb some energy as a rebound when we put force down, and then we come up towards the knee. So the knee being the transitory joint, it passes on the force towards the hip. And now from the hip, we'll move into the upper section of the body there. So today we're gonna be focused on understanding force generation from the ground up and how we can transmit force from the bottom up for you to stay well connected with good balance and equilibrium. So today's video, we're gonna be showing you how to lower your body's center of gravity to attain better balance and control and activate the major muscles that need to be working for your posture and helping you walk better in a more efficient manner. So we're gonna go to the screen and briefly I'm gonna show you the connections there. Then we're gonna move on into the exercise part. We're gonna be releasing your shins and part of your quads and the tensor fascia lateral muscle there. That is very important for us to have more freedom in our hips. And then I'll show you how to do a couple of exercises where you're gonna lower your center of gravity and you're gonna be able to move around in different directions. So the idea that I'm bringing up to you for exercising, go out of the traditional way of doing your squats and your lunges and bending pattern, pushing and pull. We wanna bring out a different way for you to access the body in a much more easier way that it will be more beneficial just using tensile force on your body, using the floor, spreading your feet away and open them up to the sides too. So we're gonna work on that today. Okay, let's go to the screen and check this out. Okay, so we have the back part of the hips right here. So I'm gonna start building it up and you can see how right away we get some connected tissue right onto the sacroiliac area right through here and on the capsules of the hip joint. Then we continue having now the connected tissue to the spinal process right here. And now look at the bridging right here. That's how the two pelvis gets together right here. Okay, it's a bridging, and look at this guy right here too. These ligaments are super strong right there. Then builds up some more strength right through here. And now you can finalize seeing this amazing structure right here of ligament tissue, very powerful strength on that positioning there. So now we're gonna bring out the tissue, the muscles part. You can start seeing how the articulation is in an oblique airway in an angle part right here. And how you start getting extensions towards the hip to rotate the hip in and out. Look at the groin, how vast and generous is and how much support we get. Look at the articulation again and the angle and how far it goes down into your femur right here. And then you can start seeing how you start generating some tissue here on the transmission force for the upper body. More tissue there at the groin area. And then I get more rotators. And then that's what I've been talking about the horizontal axis of the body, how everything gets the horizontal axis and the vertical axis coming down here. So remember, we had two legs. One leg is not firing well. Then we got to look at the balance and see how we are crossing between here and here. You can see all the hamstrings now came on. Now we start building out on the hip, on the glute area. And then you have the gluteus maximus now showing up right here. Okay, so now looking out at the body right here, you can see how it's all put together. Now I'm gonna turn it around so you can see the front of it. And now I'm gonna take away from it so you can see how it works out. And you can start seeing how, again, the front of the legs goes right here and it hooks right into the pelvis. And there's the oblique muscles right through there that it will help you stabilize your pelvis. And then again, looking at the first muscles of the quadricep right here. Now the transverse abdominal right here, it's very important for us to activate. And so that's the muscle that, force couples the lower body with the upper body. Okay, and then this is the bridge that we have through the front. And a vertical axis, there's the psoas muscle or hip flexor that hook that originates on the lumbar spine and it hooks right on the hip joint right there. All right, so that's where we are right there. That's where we started. And now we're gonna be going in to do the exercises and then we'll continue from there. We'll see you at the gym. So we're going to the floor. We're gonna be releasing the front of your lower leg, your shin area. So when you find a spot there, just try to press onto it, looking for the release. And I want to tell you that it's going to be tender. Okay, so expect some really good sensations coming out of that spot on the front of your lower leg. You can use a tennis ball too to make it easier on yourself to get started. Okay, so that will allow you to walk better. And if you're running long mileage, this will really relieve a lot of the tension on your lower leg there. Looking for a good position on your lower back too, so you can disperse the tension that you're releasing from your lower leg there. It's important. So we're gonna use the PCP pipe there. And we're looking for the bridge between your hip joint and the pelvis there, so look for the hip pointer there that it could be sore. Most of us will have that area there's really sore on that little section there. And again, the idea of this is for you to release the IT band tendon versus just going to the IT band and trying to release that without really working on the muscle that is holding it tight. Next, we're gonna work on connecting to the ground. We're going to use the ground force tension, and I'm looking to spread the floor, pushing my right leg back and my left leg forward. Spread it out and then squeeze in. As I'm coming down, I'm squeezing and standing up and spreading the floor. Very important to get connected here. You're gonna have a distinctive feeling there on the back in front of your leg. So now we're gonna activate the glutes by going outward. And inside, when we press inside, we activate the groin there. Again, you know, it's just activating the whole hip joint as a unit together with your feet and knees. So now we're gonna look into getting a better center of gravity to bend our body, so we hinge right at the hip. And again, connecting with the ground is very, very important there. So we're looking to go down into towards the floor by bending the knee at 90 degrees. Okay, so this activity will really help you, this exercise will help you to go down to the floor and get reached down to things that are difficult to reach at times. Most important to take your shoes off and on. That's a good challenge to have. Looking for the mobility part again, connecting for your feet, knee, and hip. Okay, very important for you to see how everything is moving as a unit and how the vertical axis and horizontal axis is working. I show you this motion here, so you can see how the foot leads the motion as we turn in. It's very important for us to pay attention to that. And please leave us some comments below and let us know if you have any questions so we can answer those and then continue working with you. So keep on moving and then we'll see you next week. Continue this process of getting better shape and better communication with your body. Keep on moving.